Okay, so this is what I understood after spending months and months trying to understand what happened here. So, since school, we've been taught that E is equal to mc square, where E is energy, m is mass, and c is the speed of light. This has been the cornerstone of each and every equation and everything basically that we've learned in physics. So, what this means, or what this can be used to derive, is that anything that has mass, it cannot attain the speed of light. Like the speed of light, which is 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 meters per second, which is really fast, it cannot be attained by anything if it has mass. So what CERN did? Well, they decided, let's fuck this. We will challenge this theory and we will prove it wrong. So that's exactly what they did. They accelerated two particles with very little mass, but mass nonetheless. They had mass and they accelerated them to the speed of light. Now, how they managed to do this? They built this huge, huge circle, a tunnel sort of a thing, a tube with electromagnets all around it, and used it to accelerate particles. Now, I don't know the whole physics behind it, but they achieved it. That much is documented. They achieved it. So they accelerated particles to the speed of light, and these particles had mass. So now, when something that has mass and goes near the speed of light, and it collides in a very small space, mind you, it produces massive, massive amounts of energy, like unimaginable amounts of energy. Like it's comparable to the Big Bang, apparently. That's what they were trying to achieve, to find out what happened in the beginning of time, how the universe was formed. So this massive amount of energy that was released, it couldn't be possibly controlled. So what this did was that it ripped a hole in space-time, the very fabric of space-time, and it can be seen here. And this, according to me, is what the portal, let's just call it that, which was the hole in time space space-time, whatever you want to call it, which was ripped due to the massive amounts of uncontrolled energy that was released by the collision of those particles which had mass and were going at the speed of light. Okay, I hope you guys are not overwhelmed. So, just to review where we are, E is equal to mc square, where E is the energy, m is mass, c is speed of light, which can be used to derive that nothing with mass can be accelerated, sorry, to the speed of light. And CERN guys fucked this theory in the ass. They made this possible. They accelerated particles with a little bit of mass to the speed of light, made them collide, and the amount of energy released led to a hole being ripped apart in the fabric of space-time. Now, okay, assuming our timeline as being one and another similar parallel timeline being two. See, there's this theory which states that there are infinite numbers of timelines where all of us exist, and we exist under similar circumstances, but minute details might change, which are really hard to notice. So, our timeline from the beginning of time has been our timeline, another timeline has been another timeline. So, not to confuse them, we're gonna call them one, which is our timeline, and two, which is another similar timeline. Now, what happened is both the timelines were going on their own path, since time is linear and it can move only forward, or it should be. So, in 2012, or whenever they successfully made this collision happen, our timeline, it ceased to exist. Or timeline 2 ceased to exist, but I due to a lot of examples, I believe that I am from timeline 1, so I'm just gonna call that our timeline. So it ceases to exist. And another timeline with similar history throughout, with some small gaps, some glitches, that is the one that managed to survive. And our timeline, because of that hole in space-time, our timeline, it was able to merge with that timeline. And the things that we remember from our timeline might have happened, and we might be right about them, but the reason other people remember them differently is because they're from timeline 2. And nobody really realized what happened until they started noticing all of this. So I don't know how much of this is plausible. It's all theory, and I'm no physicist, but after all the I'm very far away from physicist. I'm a medical student. So well, what I understood after all the research and time and effort I put into this, and trust me, I have put some time, so this is it. Both the timelines fused because of what they did, either because of what they did at CERN, or some, maybe there might be some other explanation, but this is what I understood. And this led to the Mandela effect. So tell me what you guys think.